What's up? It's your boy Finally's Case Love. This episode will say gluck to the cast tonight, man. And today will mark the return of John Caldwell, the defenseman. John Caldwell will be returning for the Caps lineup. He missed like 36 games due to an injury. So he hadn't played since, I think, about almost 3 months, since December 23rd. And so the Caps are 18-10-2 in 30 games, which Carlson has played. So, yeah, it's been like an up and down season for us, man. Up and down season. So hopefully Caps can really bounce back. Now you got Carlson back. So, yeah, guys that have kind of been out for a while. Yeah, Nick Backstrom came back. Tom Wilson just came back. So, this has been kind of a difficult season for the Caps. But hopefully we can now pretty much got the whole gang together. So that it's like, wow, it's kind of like it's been so long since I mentioned his name on here. So it's kind of hard to mention his name, but I'm glad to see him back, see how he do, and see how the Caps will do tonight. And yeah, it's like his presence has been missed so much, man. And I kind of forgot about him too, because all this, you know, it's like Ovechkin was getting all the attention this year with the breaking the record and the goaltime goals and all everything. So he's even though number two, but so it's pretty much been great. So been a great season for us, like far as like on Ovi getting the records, but now get the great news that John Carlson is coming back is pretty much music to my ears. And he's officially, I officially named one of the first stars of the week. Even though he's just getting back, but he is nice to see him back. And also him and Ovechkin, also two stars so far. Like an early two stars. I don't know if I'll do one tomorrow or do one this week, but John Carlson so far gets the first star of the week. So it's your boy Finally's Case Love. Make sure you join the Cash at Dollside with the tweet. So let's go Caps. Lisa Ferry, beat them Blackhawks tonight. Yeah.
Dylan hammers that one. Ouch. Oh my goodness, that hit John Carlson. John Carlson being tended to immediately.
He's under the care of team physicians, being transported to the local hospital.
Hope he's all right. All well, my right now with him.
John Carlson, he's been out since late December. Huge loss for them.
It's difficult. Difficult being on the outside. It's a different kind of intensity. It's a different kind of aware on the body and the mind.
Carlson from the angle. Score!
Feel really good. Feel rejuvenated. The major hurdles are behind me. You know, get ready for coming back. Yeah, it feels great. It feels, like a normal routine again. Normal, just stuff that you're used to. I think that's the hardest part is, you know, coming in at different times, being in different spots, being away, being home. It's, it doesn't feel the same, and I'm glad to be back here now.
What are you looking most forward to tonight?
Just playing hockey. I think, you know, you put in a lot of work all summer long, all season long, all rehab long, whatever it is. It's you want to go out there and use it. I think that's what we all want to do is play the game we love and have fun with it. And that's what I'm going to be doing.
Any nerves?
Yeah, definitely. It's a lot different than other regular season games in my career. That's for sure. Yeah.
Did you ever have a doubt when you were going through this process that this would happen this year? Or are you always?
I guess you could have. You know, anyone could have thought that, yeah. And I'm sure at some point I had, but like most everyone else in here, I would imagine we're pretty goal-oriented people. And when you have a target, a goal, a conversation, you got to have something to work to, and obviously it's not always that simple. It doesn't always go as planned. Some parts are harder, some parts are easier, and whatever it is, I think we all have goals in here, and that's certainly, I had a goal to come back if it was safely possible, and that's where I'm at.
John, when you say nerves, you've had gaps, not this long, and you know, for a very different type of injury.
Yeah.
Are the nerves related to the nature
of
the injury?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's, you know, you get more and more used to it. Obviously, from day one of me skating on the ice by myself to, you know, integrating into practices and, you know, playing some, you know, pseudo live play and all that. I think it just continues to get real, but there's only so much that you can do in terms of that, especially at this point in the year. You know, and now we you test it out on the ice. That's all that's left to do, and certainly that's a big factor.
Sure. Did you when you were rehabbing, did you kind of envision this day and mentally just think about getting to this day as you kind
yeah
of
yeah I think with no return date, it makes it pretty miserable for anyone, even if it's you know, say a 3 to 4 week injury. I think if you don't know, if you don't have something that you're striving for, it makes it a lot more difficult. And you know, we're all professionals in here, the trainers, the doctors, they're all on board with everything. And like I said before, sometimes it doesn't always work out to be that 3 to 4 weeks or whatever it may be, but regardless of what it turns into, you know, you have to have a goal. I think mentally is just a lot easier on yourself to work towards something instead of just kind of be working hard and hopefully one day they tap you on the shoulder and say, okay, yeah, now you can play.
You kind of mentioned this, but, you know, like with a knee or a hip or an ankle, there's that first hit, right? Okay, I'm okay.
Mm-hmm.
Is there that first time you get hit high with a puck or you see a guy winding up and you're in the slot? Is there kind of, have you had that yet?
Yeah, I mean, for sure, yeah. You hear a puck coming around the glass or something and you don't quite know where it is. Those are all, I mean, they're nerve-wracking things regardless of, of anything. And you can't discount that. But, yeah, of course, just different situations. You have to be in it to, you know, to either, A, know how you feel, or B, kind of return to normal. So that's, you know, that's where I'm at.
Late December, there were a lot of unknowns. Was there a point over these past few weeks or couple of months where late March or at least before the end of the regular season where it became more realistic?
Yeah, I mean, this is, yeah, it's, I think from, like I said before, from day one, we've had a goal in mind to return into the regular season. And, you know, it's certainly, it could have been anything. You know, it could have been 2 weeks ago or it could have been, you know, a month from now. It's not perfect. No thing like this is perfect, and this is where we're at, and I'm excited to be here.
How long was this date circled calendar on your calendar?
Probably, you know, closer to that 2 month mark, you really start talking and you know, not just say here's a hope or a goal and let's work to something. And obviously, more can happen along the way from that point to now. But thankfully, everything went great, and here we are.
Gordie Howe.
He scores! Gordie Howe!
Alex Ovechkin.
What a goal by Alexander Ovechkin! Unstoppable!
Two men who each define a generation of hockey, both born with talent, will, and the natural ability to score. Over his 26 seasons, Howe led the league in scoring 6 times.
Howe gets the rebound. He scores!
Rewriting the record books along the way.
Howe shoots. He scores! He's done it! Gordie Howe is hockey's all-time leading goal scorer.
His 801 career goals was the NHL standard until 1994.
Gordie Howe, hockey's greatest player.
Howe transcended the game, bringing millions of new fans to his beloved sport.
Representing all of hockey with great distinction for 5 decades, number 9.
Mr. Hockey was the standard until 2005, when a 20-year-old phenom burst on the scene.
Alexander Ovechkin, welcome on board.
I love score goals. I love win game. I love hockey. It's like a little boy have candy and he love it. So I'm a big boy, I love hockey and I have hockey.
Alex may have entered the NHL like a kid in the candy store, but he has played like a bull in a china shop ever since.
He scores! Simply sensational! He scores! Ovechkin!
He's led the league in goals 9 times.
Absolutely brilliant! Oh, what a play!
Had 9 50-goal seasons.
Goal number 50!
Number 5-0! Unbelievable!
Scored nearly 300 power play goals.
You know it's coming, and you still can't stop it.
Ekstrom brings it in. Ovechkin scores!
And I've been fortunate to assist on a couple hundred of those goals.
Number 400!
600!
700 red lights!
800 goals! Listen to this crowd!
Fans flock to the great ace. He's the game's biggest and best ambassador, taking hockey worldwide.
Ovechkin at the line, feeds it. Kuznetsov doesn't want to shoot it. There it is! There it is! Alex Ovechkin has overtaken Mr. Hockey.
Historical moment, only 3 players scored 800, and one of them is me, so it's pretty nice to be around the kind of history.
One great hill left to climb.
Number one, the great one, Wayne Gretzky, looms just ahead.
I don't think somebody will beat this record. I think it's impossible.
Impossible to catch Gretzky?
It's impossible.
So, all that's left to do now is the impossible.